Hi, beauties. Welcome back. So today we are doing, it's hands down our most popular segment. It is Ipsy versus Ipsy, the Plus edition. If you are joining us for the first time, welcome. Basically what I do is my mother has an Ipsy Plus and a normal Ipsy. I have an Ipsy Plus and a normal Ipsy. Each month I take both of these bags, hers and mine, and I compare the two. I open it up, I pick out my favorite bag as a total, and then I pick out my five favorite products from what they were given to make the ideal bag. That being said, with the new changes to Ipsy Plus, it has kind of made it a little different. I used to not check my spoilers besides the one customization option that I was given. And now obviously I know everything that's in the bag. I was with my mom and she did hers as well. So I know what she got too. Although I kind of am forgetting what she got, if I'm being honest, because my memory sucks. But yeah, so it's kind of changed a little bit, but I still like to do the unboxings and show you guys what I got and then still pick out from after having been able to hold them and see them in person, be able to pick out what I think was the best bag and which one would order my favorite products from that. Yeah, I can talk and keep a train of thought, kinda. We both added add-ons. I only did a small one for this one, and I actually went back and added a couple other things onto my little bag. She added a ton, that's why hers is huge and heavy. And hers actually showed up early this month, and normally mine does, so it was very weird, but we've been waiting on mine and it's finally here. I always start with mom's bag, so we're gonna do that today as well. I will say, just quickly, if you haven't subscribed, please do so. We're in the middle of Spooktober, which is Halloween is my favorite time of year, hands down, and we are about to kick off our Halloween. It starts Sunday, October 25th, and we are doing 7 days straight of really intricate makeup looks. All themed around obviously Halloween costumes or Halloween ideas. And I'm telling cool stories too, because I have a history degree. So I've just been researching the shit out of different fun topics. So yes, please subscribe. We'd love for you to be part of our family. We're fun. We do lots of crazy fun stuff here. So let's get into it. I'm trying to I think it's everything is separated based on what she, I should have, last month she printed off. She printed off what she actually chose and then what she added on. And I did not ask her to do that this time. And I gotta remember now. And I just told you guys I don't do well remembering. So, all right, I think I've got it. It may be wrong, but we'll roll with it. First things first, I love everything about the bag. I love the design, I love it. I think it's perfect for Halloween. I just absolutely love it. I was hoping they were going to sell the big bags, the premium, because that's the only one, premium, I think that's the right term. I don't know, I don't know what's happening in my brain right now, I'm so sorry. But yeah, I was hoping they were gonna sell those bags separately. I'm still hoping they might after this month is done, like in November they might have them, because I will buy it to have the whole collection, because that's the only box I don't have and I really loved this design so much. So yeah, huge fan of the bags. Love, love it, love it. So what mom got, I believe for her they chose, I remember her choosing this. This is the double feature. It's a little lip gloss duo, lipstick and lip gloss duo, I think, from Half Caked. And the packaging on it, I love it, so cute. I know this was one of my options to choose too in my final round, and I didn't wind up choosing it because I think I got an eye cream or something instead. Oh yeah, good size and really pretty colors. Very nice neutral matte lipstick, which is what I normally go for. The reason I didn't opt to get this, even though I love that it had two products, is I just don't wear lip glosses very often. So I was like, I love this shade, don't use this a lot. And for mine, I know the eye cream I was gonna use more. So that's why I went with it. But that's a really cute set. I kind of am kicking myself for not doing it as an add-on because I know that was available. But yeah, cute, love the packaging, really adorable. It's a little dark for her. So we'll see if she winds up using it, but overall, I'm a fan of it. This one's all packaged up nicely, so I'm not going to do it, but this is the Filorga, I think that's the name, Laboratories Filorga Paris, Youth Performance Oxygen Glow Eye Serum. I got this as well, I know I did. I chose, in fact, I was the one who convinced her to get it because I was like, I looked into it, seems pretty legit, and she was like, all right. She also got the Dr. Brandt Pore Dermabrasion Exfoliator. I love Dr. Brandt. I think I got this in my bag last month. I love Dr. Brandt. This is a great product, expensive product. This is like a retail value, like $60. So yeah, this is a great thing. She was kind of like, I don't really need it because she doesn't like exfoliating ones that much. And I was like, I mean, I'll take it. But she was disappointed with her choices, I know. I like her bag though. I'm a big fan of it. I think this is one of the things they chose for her. This is from Lovecraft Beauty. It's a highlight palette. It is so gorgeous. Online, I think a lot of times with Ipsy's pictures, online is not done, it doesn't do it justice because you get it in person, you're like, wow, that's a really pretty shade. Borealis and Aurora are the two shades, and Borealis is this really gorgeous golden shade, and this is something that I could see myself wearing pretty much daily. One of my favorite highlighters is Blissful from Ofra, and it's this nice golden. It kind of gives you the sun-kissed look, and I feel like that's going to be a very similar finish to it. So I'm interested to see how she winds up liking that. The last thing that she got in her bag is the Freematic Eyeshadow Pro from Douce, I think is the name of the company. I don't know. You guys know I can't pronounce things. I'm sorry. Pretty. Really pretty, actually. Nice little 8 eyeshadows, and then you got a highlighter as well. I almost did this as an add-on because it was only $12, but I decided not to because I wasn't sure if I was going to like the shades. But the nice thing about it is it actually, like, kind of, it looks like they are magnetic. Oh, they do. They pop out so you can replace them. That's cool. That's a really cool, I like that idea. If I had known that, I probably would have bought it. So hindsight, man. But yeah, pretty. I like her bag. I think it's well worth $25. Honestly, alone, the skincare stuff, which you guys, if you've been with us for a long time, you're probably like, you've changed, girl. And I have, because 2020, I don't do a lot of makeup. I do a ton of skincare though. So now I'm like, skincare products, yes. I still prefer makeup, but I can definitely appreciate the skincare products much more now. So let's do her quickly. Let's do what she added on. She did add on one of the Tarte Shape Tape setting powders, which I believe I got in my bag. Great product, obviously. I love setting powders, and Tarte's one of my favorite brands. So yeah, absolutely great little deal there. Then she got, I don't even remember what this is. Oh, this is the Kung Fu Apothecary, I hope I say this right, Gua Sha tool. It's like a nice little, it's a sculpting tool, and you basically use it to shape your face. Like a rolling, like one of the rollers, the jade rollers or the rose quartz rollers. I have a jade roller. I actually got two of them and gave one to my mom, and that's how she first started doing this kind of stuff. So she did buy one of those because she's really into that. I think especially because she's, you know, has much more mature skin to keep wrinkles and stuff at bay. She's very into that kind of stuff. And so she was like, yeah, I wanted to try it. And I was like, I don't know, I don't blame you. She also got the Kate Somerville KX Active Concentrates, the bio-mimicking peptides. It is to smooth and firm. She uses these kind of serums all the time. I think this was like an $18 add-on. I almost got one as well. I love Kate Somerville, but I just was trying not to, I was trying hard not to spend like another $100 in Ipsy products. So I was very, very limited in what I added. She did get the 111 Skin Cryo ATP Sports Booster as well. She got the Sunday Riley CEO Brightening Serum with Vitamin C. And then her final product is this nice little blending brush, which is actually what I added on, and I convinced her to get as well. So yeah, I think if I remember correctly, this was like a $25 add-on. I think these were all $18, this one too maybe. The brush was only $3, and I think the apothecary tool was only $12 maybe. So she definitely spent a good amount of money on add-ons, but I think what she got is some great stuff. And honestly, I think she was a little disappointed with what her choices were. So in order to make it seem like worth it, she did the add-ons. I like it. I like everything she got. I'm a big fan of it. I'm gonna stand by. I really do think that the changes that Ipsy Plus has made definitely revolutionized what the subscription box game is looking like, especially for them in terms of this. But I'm just a fan of it. I've yet to be disappointed with anything. My choices this month weren't my favorite, but I still got solid stuff. We'll look at it in just a second. But yeah, so that's mom's bag. A lot of add-ons. Mine doesn't have that many add-ons, so we won't spend that much time with it. I'm gonna have to just shove it all away. I like to try and keep it out sometimes, so when I pick out my 5 favorite products, I can see them, but that's not gonna happen this time, so. I got the same little bag, obviously. Love it, I'm so into it. Now I will say, this is another bag, second bag, 2 months in a row, I've gotten 2 palettes. That to me is huge. Palettes are my thing. I will always choose a palette. Unless it really is just not my color scheme, I'm gonna choose the palette. That's how I feel about it. I actually had the choice to get another palette when I chose one of the palettes, and I should have gone with that one. I'm kicking myself because I was hoping I could buy it in add-ons and I couldn't do that, but what are you gonna do? First thing, what they chose for me, do you remember what they chose for me? They chose the Tarte setting powder for me. Love it. Highly recommend it. Love getting setting powders because I'm always flying through powders, and foundations and concealers are something I just love, both in liquid form and powder form for foundation. So I'm into it. I was like, good choice. Ipsy, I see ya. You know me. I got the Lovecraft Beauty eyeshadow palette, and they had two different colors, and they chose one that's, it's not really what I would say is my aesthetic. Because of that, I don't have a lot of palettes that look like this. In fact, I don't have really anything I think that looks like this. And it's very much October vibey for me. Like, I see this and I go, oh, I could do such a cool gothic look with this, and I want to do it. Like, I probably will do a video doing that because I just think it's adorable. So yeah, I was very happy with the two choices they did for me. I was like, that's, yes, I agree with those. Good job, Ipsy. Now my first customization choice was, I had this palette, which is the Moods from Laura Sanchez, I think. That's correct. Yes, Moods from Laura Sanchez. This little palette. Then I also had the choice between the Violet Voss Creme Brulee palette. The Violet Voss colors are much more ones that I would gravitate towards, but this was a higher value palette. And so I said, well, I'm gonna get this in my bag and I'm gonna hope I can add on the Violet Voss one, and I could not. So I cucked myself there, but what are you gonna do? But the nice thing about this palette is it comes with a lot of really gorgeous variations and shit. I feel like there's a lot you can do with this, and you get four mattes, you get four shimmery bright colors, and then you get two really pretty highlighters, and it comes with a brush. So when I've gotten in past Ipsy's, my little bag, I've gotten like individuals of the Moods collection from Laura Sanchez, and I really enjoyed the formula. So I was like, it wasn't a bad choice. It just, if I had known, I might have gone with something different. But I'm very excited that I got this. I am excited to play around with it too and see what we can do with that. The next thing I chose was that Oxygen Glow Eye Cream. I'm excited about it. I've been using eye creams a ton, and I've realized that I actually don't have as many as I thought. I went and separated everything out, and I only have like a couple ones that I really gravitate towards. So I was like, all right, let's try a new one. I need a couple more. And then I was wrong. I did not choose an eye cream. The last thing that I chose instead of the lipstick was this. It is the Thrive Cosmetics Bright Eye Brightener. It is a highlight stick and a crayon eyeshadow. And I chose to get it because I'm actually a huge fan of crayon eyeshadows. Oh, cute little teal container. And I really like, oh yeah, really gorgeous color in fact. Let's see. Hopefully you guys can see that. Very neutral, very, I really think that would be absolutely a beautiful highlighter. I think it also, if you're just doing a really subtle eye look, it would be very pretty. And I love it. It's this kind of like almost light copper shade. And I think for Thanksgiving time, fall, after we get out of Halloween, it'll be a really nice, like a nice little addition to my collection. So I'm happy that with that choice as well. And then of course I did get this, and I had to get this brush because look at it, it looks like a wand. Like crystallized, it's purple, and I've now learned, mom used to complain about getting brushes a lot. I used to kind of be like neutral about it. I actually love getting brushes, especially eyeshadow brushes, because the more I have, the longer I can go in between washing them. And then I have to spend like 5 hours washing 100 brushes. But you know what? It's, if I can go a couple months instead of having to do it every other week or so, I'll do it. So yeah. So I've been buying a lot more brushes and stuff on add-ons lately because I like having backups more or less. So yeah, so that's my bag. I liked this month. I'm a big fan. So yeah, let's pick out favorite bag. I'm gonna say it's mine. And then if I had to pick out my five top products, I'm gonna go with my eyeshadow palette. And I know it's from the same company, but I'm actually gonna go with the Lovecraft highlight palette for mom. So that's one for me, one for mom. I'm gonna go with, we both got the eye cream, so I guess that technically counts for both. So, but I'm gonna go with that as well. I am gonna choose my Moods palette. And I'm actually gonna say for my fifth product, I think I, instead of the Tarte, I think I would choose the Thrive. But it's hard because her lip glosses were really, her lipstick duo I really liked as well. So yeah, good month for Ipsy. I wasn't sure about it, but now seeing all my products in front of me, I'm very happy with everything. I like the changes. I'm a big fan. I'm excited to see what our standard bag looks like. We did check before we sat down to film this, and it is still not here, neither one of them. So as soon as it does get here, we'll film it. We'll get it up for you guys. But yeah, let me know what you got. I love seeing what you guys you got in the comments, and if you were happy with your choices and all that, definitely subscribe. I'm really excited about what we've got going on for Halloween. We filmed already a couple of the videos, and I think they turned out really cool. I think it's gonna be a really, really cool thing, and something that I hope that we can continue to do in years to come, and maybe even make it like the whole month. It's gonna take a lot of planning to do that, but like, you know, eventually you gotta start somewhere and then you get to grow. So yeah, definitely subscribe. If you like the video, thumbs up, it helps us a ton. And other than that, I hope you guys are all safe and healthy. You have a wonderful day and you stay girly with the dark twist.